Good morning from the car, guys. This is Vlogmas day 20. It is 5:32 in the morning right now. Peter, I, and Kobe are currently on the way back to Ottawa. It is pitch black outside still, which is why it looks so dark in the car. I have like the little car light turned up top here so you guys can see, kind of ish, a little bit of me. But we are headed on our way back to Ottawa. I'm get back on time so that we can offload everything in the car before I have to make it to my doctor's appointment. Sorry, my dentist appointment. My dentist appointment is at 10 o'clock in the morning. It usually takes us around like 4 to 4.5 hours to get back to Ottawa, so we'll see how it goes. But I don't think we've driven back to Ottawa this early in the morning in a long time.
Not in years.
Not in years. We usually actually leave at nighttime around like 6 o'clock, or we leave at like 9 a.m. in the morning. So like more morning, less like dawn morning. Sorry, I had to adjust because Kobe kept trying to climb up onto the camera. The roads are surprisingly clear right now just because there's nobody headed to work just quite yet. So I'm hoping that this makes for an easy ride out of Toronto, and then once we're on the highways, maybe they won't be as clogged. So we'll see. If I happen to fall asleep, which is probably really likely on this drive back home, I will see you guys back in Ottawa and you'll know what time we get there and if I make it to my dentist appointment on time. Because I did not really sleep last night. I think I slept like 1 hour. I stayed up editing a lot of stuff. So pretty tired at the moment. It kind of feels like I pulled an all-nighter, but I'll check in with you guys in a little bit. All right, guys, so it is 9:25 right now. It took us around 4 hours to get back to Ottawa. Less? Yeah, was it less? That's actually really good.
I know, I'm good.
I think this is the fastest we've ever gotten back to Ottawa. As you guys probably just saw in like a quick little clip, I woke up to show you what Ottawa looks like because Toronto had like some snow, but it wasn't that pretty. And I woke up here and I was like, oh my God, it's so cute. It's very fresh and white. There's actually so much more snow than Toronto, as to be expected, because this is when it's usually like this time of the year. But I'm going to drop my stuff off at my house right now and then head over to my dental appointment. To give you guys an idea of how much snow Ottawa gets, and this is like not even the beginning of the season really, that's a huge pile.
This
is literally nothing compared to what we usually get, but it's nice. It's clean, it's fresh right now, so yeah. Hey guys, it's been a few hours now since I chatted with you. Since then, I have gone to my dentist appointment. I didn't bring the camera in because I figured that they probably wouldn't want cameras inside filming them while I was getting my teeth cleaned and getting a filling. I got two fillings, one at the top, one at the bottom here. The bottom one, surprisingly, they actually didn't need to numb me for, so it was just the inside of my tooth, and they just drilled into it and told me that if it started to hurt, put up my hand and then he would numb me. Otherwise, it would have like numbed my entire jaw down to my neck, which is nice because I would not have preferred to have half my face frozen. He did numb me on the top here though for the top filling. So this side of my mouth is still kind of like sore. I think most of the numbing on the extremities has faded away, like my lips are no longer numb, my tongue is no longer numb. It's just like the inside muscles of a gum feel kind of sore. And I don't know if that leftover soreness is just like where the needles went in and where they did the work in my mouth, but that's good now. I got home, ate a little bit of lunch, caught up with my mom, and then took like a nice little nap. And now Peter's picked me up. We're headed to go fill out our marriage license and file it so that we can be officially married in January. So we have to set an appointment for that. So I will take you guys with me there. I doubt I can also take the camera there actually because it's government offices. I don't think so, right?
No.
No, I don't think so. So we'll see what happens. Otherwise, I'll just show you the paperwork that's been filed afterwards and then we can be not married yet. We'll have the license applied for, but the date booked.
Arrived. We're gonna go sign our papers. Are you ready? I can't tell if you're happy or not.
So about an hour and a half later, we have applied for our marriage license and we have set a date for January 13th at 11 o'clock in the morning. So we're gonna get officially and legally married that day. And then we'll have the actual ceremony on May 24th. So I originally wanted January 12th. I can't remember, did I say this already?
I don't know, I don't know what you
said. I wanted January 12th because that was the day Peter proposed to me, but unfortunately it's a Sunday and they don't perform the ceremonies on Sunday, so we had to make do with the next day, but I'm excited! We will be back here in a few weeks' time to get our wedding ceremony. So heading off to the mall to run some errands for my mom, pick up some stuff for Christmas, and then we'll go home. We're in the mall now, just got here parked, heading into Victoria's Secret to pick up some stuff for my mom because she wants some things for a birthday or a Christmas present. And then we are going to head home so that Peter can go to a dinner at his grandparents afterwards, and I'm just gonna go back home and sleep. Get it in. Let's go look for stuff. When's the last time you were in Victoria's Secret? A long time ago. Have you ever come in here with me, actually?
Why would I go in here with you?
I don't know. Help me pick stuff.
I don't care about this store.
Package acquired. Now it's time to hit home. Okay, guys. So, essentially, ran my errands, came back home, and it's been a few hours now, but honestly, all I really did for the remainder of the day... Oh, hi, Copes. Where are you? He's over here. Behind me somewhere. He's chilling on my bed. This is my childhood bedroom, guys. If you haven't watched any of my vlogs from last year, Vlogmas, this is it. I have a bunch of different pictures of my friends from childhood. And yes, my bedroom is yellow. Let me know if you kind of want like a childhood bedroom tour. I can show you that. Nothing much has really changed. Like, I've always tried to change stuff slowly over the years, but it's just stayed pretty consistent since I don't really spend a lot of time here. The only thing that has like solidly changed is my bed decor. I have added a lot of more pink accents because I decided I want a very white, pink, and beige theme for this bedroom. But everything else has relatively stayed the same, and I'm just the type of person who hoards things and I can't get rid of stuff, so everything stays the way it is. But after we came home, all I did was sleep for a few hours because I was so exhausted. What happens after you sleep for 1 hour and then have on and off sleep for 3 or 4 hours in the car leaves you a little mentally insane. I think what I'm gonna do is probably just end the vlog right here. I know it wasn't that exciting. It was very, very short. I apologize about that, but I promise tomorrow's will be a little bit longer. There's gonna be more exciting things. I also have a video coming out of like my top 5 must-have winter boots for the season that I pre-filmed for you guys in Toronto. I'm gonna put up for one of these days just because I wanted to give myself a little bit more downtime while I was here with the fam, so I wouldn't have to film every single day. And I may actually use that for tomorrow or the next day's vlog so that I don't have to carry the camera with me every day when I'm hanging out with my cousins. But so that you guys can still have content for Vlogmas. I know I'm a little bit behind in Vlogmas as well since I didn't get any vlogs up yesterday. And I apologize for that. But it's been a hectic couple of days, guys. And I hope you can understand from the bottom of my heart from me and Kobe. We thank you. You guys can't really see him. We thank you so much for following along on all of the Vlogmas journey. And I'm actually really proud that I have yet to skip a day this year in this year's Vlogmas. I probably jinxed myself from saying that just now, actually. But so far, so good. I mean, we're almost like 20 days in, this will be. Yeah, 20 days into Vlogmas. I think I've done a good job. All I have are another like 5 more days to go. We can do it. Almost there. Almost at the end of it. And to be very honest, I think reflecting back, from my heart to heart that I had about like a week ago with you guys, that doing some of the pre-film videos actually like really, really helped me out this year in the sense that I didn't have to film a video every single day. And I think going forward for next year, that's definitely a method that I'm going to move forward with. It made sense so that some days that were slower or some days where I just need to sit down and literally just like hammer out work the whole time and I had nothing to show for it, if I had a pre-filmed video, I could just throw it up and it would fill a space. Not in the sense that I don't want to produce vlogs for you guys, because I do want to, but I also want to produce the highest quality vlogs and vlogs that make sense and content that is of value to you. And there's always videos during the holidays that I really want to produce for you anyways as well that aren't going to fall into the realm of vlogs. I also noticed a lot of comments on my blog asking me for my skincare routine for winter, for daytime and nighttime, things about like my favorite beauty products that I recommend, my hair care routine as well, which I never thought you guys would actually even care about, but apparently some people do. So I'm gonna be probably compiling a whole blog post together of those things. I'm thinking of doing like a Best in Beauty 2019 edition for like beauty, skincare, makeup, and hair, that sort of thing. You guys will probably see that in the blog. But yeah, it seems like you guys care about specific everyday products that I use and you guys really enjoyed that. So I'm still obviously going to be able to provide those types of content for next year's Vlogmas. I've also toyed with the idea of renaming my Vlogmas just because Vlogmas is like a very vague overall title for everything. But I want to personalize it. I want to make one for you guys so that you feel that like you're here for my content and not just Vlogmas in general. So I've toyed around with the name Listmas because on Instagram my name is The Lust List and I have not changed it to my personal name yet. Or I can also make it like very basic Vicmas. But I felt like Listmas had more of like, I don't know, rolled off the tongue a little bit better. So let me know what you guys think. If you have any specific ideas, if you guys have even made it this far in this video to be able to hear this little idea of mine to rename Vlogmas next year, let me know if you like Listmas.
or Vicmas, or you guys have any other better ideas out there for what I should be naming my Vlogmas for next year, because I want to give it a little bit more of like a personal ring. But I think I'm going to end today's vlog here. Thank you so much, guys, for tuning in and watching this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to always give it a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments down below what other type of content you want to see in my channel. Actually, what would you guys like to see upcoming in 2019? I feel like this whole year I spent committing to just like YouTubing in general, and I feel like I did a good job being consistent at it, but I want to deliver content that you guys want to be able to see as well. And this is not just a standard I have no ideas what to do anymore from the YouTuber, so like asking their audience what they want to see. I just want to make sure the content that I'm creating for you guys actually makes sense and it is of value to you. I don't want to produce content that you guys don't care about. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below if you guys want to see more like beauty skincare stuff, if you want to see more travel logs, if you want to see more outfit stuff, how to style, fashion, that sort of thing. What type of videos do you guys like to see? Let me know. I'll try to deliver in 2019 because I always want to give you guys the best of value when it comes to content, of course. And if you guys haven't already followed me on Instagram, make sure to check me out right here. I post at least once to twice a day. I may slow down a little bit between now and New Year's just because it's getting a little bit hectic and I want to spend some time with the family without having to think about Instagram all the time. You can also follow me on Twitter over here. I post every like day or second day, some stuff sometimes. These two platforms I'm pretty active on all throughout the year, every single day, more or less. A little bit more than YouTube. So if you want to catch me in there, you definitely can. And yeah, I hope you guys have an awesome day. I will see you in tomorrow's Vlogmas. Bye!